relax. Slippers there by the chair. Not a worry, not a care. Along comes Junior, swinging his little axe.
Tell me a story, tell me a story, tell me a story. Remember what you said. Tell me about the bird and bee. How do you make the chicken sneeze? Tell me a story, then I'll go to bed.
Not now, Junior.
Story time at Grandma's. Two little girls at Grand's home for the night, begging for one more story before morning's light.
And sometimes as you stand at the bottom rail of a bridge, lean over and watch the river slipping away slowly beneath you, set you to take up. You'll suddenly know everything that there is to be known.
You tell the best stories of anyone I know, Grandma.
One more story, please.
It's past your bedtime, my dear November. But since your mom and dad are coming back tomorrow, I'll tell you one more.
So this is our last story?
Then it better be a very good one.
It will, I promise. It will be the second best story ever told, my little goslings.
What's a gosling?
A gosling is a child of a...
Then your mother goose.
So begins Grandmother Goose's second best story ever told. Pretending the girls are a little older, the scene unfolds.
Land of the Last Stories. Once upon a time in the not too far future, two young girls arrived at Grand's house.
Why, hello there, my little gosling.
Margie and Grandma, look how you two have grown.
Hey, MG, you have got to stop calling us that.
How's it, Granny?
I've got some Milo's. I've got some Milo and new stories to tell. Once you get settled.
Oh, tonight? Well, that's nice, but...
Oh, right. Remember, and I need to have some screen time with our buddies.
Saws, Gran.
We'll come down just now, Granny. We just need to organize our social lives for the weekend.
Too busy with social media for grand story time routine, little do they know what the actions mean. Each time a book is forgotten, the characters shoot so fast down a slippery slide into the land of stories lost. Welcome to the island.
Easy there, Red.
Back off, Jack. It is Jack, isn't
Yes, Auntie. That was several dwarves. But who are you, Midget?
The name's Dub.
Dub, Dub.
Oh no!
I'm not gonna steal little jewels, Princess Annabee. I have my own.
Look, it's a generic Disney princesses on ya.
Tinkerbell, you still exist?
Oh, I still need to pen that. You're gonna feel that heat really hard when I stick it up your nose.
Go ahead and call me Roy. Thank you.
to be better than a puppet or donkey or just me to learn. I've had a traumatic childhood, okay?
Weren't you listening to anything Peter Pan said? The things that happened to you aren't your story. They're your history.
History? Well, I suppose you're right. So what's your story, Miss Bob?
Call me Tink. Come on, I'll tell you all about it. Do you want some fairy dust?
No thanks, Tink. I'm trying to quit.
The little guy stands strong.
We can put, yes we can. Push your jack, who's the man?
Oh look, the midget minions.
Hi Jeff, give us our stuff then.
Two. You can't keep pushing us around because we're all small.
Says who?
Says us. Now open that bag, take out our things, and scrap!
Hit the road, Jack!
Ooh! Hit the road, Jack! Don't come back no more, no more, no more, no more! Hit the road, Jack! Don't come back no more! What you say? Hit the road, Jack! Don't come back no more!
No.
Helping others. Check it out. It's
basket?
Perhaps someone stole it. Lie.
Jack.
No, it's my fault. I must have misplaced it. Don't blame him.
Yes, Red, you blame me.
Oh, thank you, thank you. I can't tell you how much this means to me.
Okay, you're right. That felt uncomfortably good.
Marjorie's grandmother is not
and Red Riding Hood. Ooh, ooh, how about the Wizard of Oz and Goldilocks?
Yes, indeed. Well, do them all. They say the Transformers book, so it might take a while.
Well, those are very good questions. Are there any parents?